Okay, you know, the scrimmage, I think, was just okay. We need, we have a lot of work to do. I'm really pleased with the offense. Offensively, I thought we really played and did some good things. Things that set us back are some typical mistakes and things that have hurt us in the past, and we got to get those corrected. You know, just getting behind the chains, any penalties, you know, a little sloppy that way. We did take care of the football, but anytime we got behind the chains, the sack or anything, negative yardage plays, was hard to overcome. But overall, they did some good things. Defensively, got a lot of work to do. You know, just disappointed. I was disappointed with the strength of our team. You know, the inexperience, the no excuse, but you know you're going to make some mistakes and some things are going to happen. But the strength of our team needs to be the strength. And today, I just didn't feel like we were up to the challenge defensively, and that's disappointing. But fortunately, we have a lot of time left to get some things rectified.
Is that lack of strength across the board, or was there a particular group?
I just, you know, like I said, just, you know, the strength of our defense and guys that with experience and that are big, strong guys and, you know, run defense, things of that nature. I just felt like we were a little out of position.
Was it any encouragement at all with the secondary?
We made a few good plays, but we got some work to do. We can't leave. You know, you guys have heard me talk about it before, you know, on both sides of the ball. Routine plays have to be routine plays. So.
Jordan Griffin is trying to take a leadership role in the second.
Oh, hold up 1 second. Tell them as they're coming in to be quiet, or else we got to move this deal. Tell them as they come in.
Jordan said he's trying to take a leadership role in the secondary. Have you seen him progress in that area?
Yeah, I mean, he's got some experience. He's played a lot of football. I mean, obviously, you know, I trust that he will do that. You know, I didn't notice it as much today, but I'm sure he will. And he means well, and he is a good kid and a good leader and has some good experience. So we need him to continue to step up.
How about B.J. Alexander? When I talked to some of the receivers on media day, they said he was kind of the guy that's being slept on right now. He's got a lot of talent. I think we're talking more so the future this year. What do you see?
Yeah, I think just continue to grow, continue to improve. We'll see. You know, he didn't feel him out that much today, but you know, he'll continue to get better.
You got to the point yet with any of the newcomers where they're forcing their way into it? I mean, this was around the time Benny's freshman year only started.
We'll see. Let me watch this film and kind of see where we're at. This is the first time I didn't. You know, I felt like the guys we talked about a bit this spring or this camp, Justin Rigg, Keaton Upshaw, they did some good things. We did hit them, you know, through the middle there. They're big targets and really make good adjustments to the ball. So that's a. I think we need to continue to build on that. That's good for Terry to have that comfort zone with targets like that and be able to throw some guys and throw them open a little bit. And they, you know, just off the cuff here right now. There are a couple guys that stood out there today. You know, Lynn did what he did early. We did a nice job of getting him the ball, and he created some plays. He didn't play a ton. He probably played 25 snaps or so, but he did some good things as well.
Now that Josh has done with his cancer treatments, what's kind of his stamina level at right now? How much are you going to be able to use him?
Josh is, you know, just, he's remarkable. You know, we've talked about it a lot, but it's just, you know, it's the truth. He's really a real inspiration to a lot of us. He got done with his treatment on, last Wednesday. Sat out Thursday and Friday, came right back out there and it was hot. It was one of those days that was very humid and hot, and he got a little sick, you know, but he doesn't want to be out. A few days prior to that, matter of fact, prior to his treatment, I had to pull him out and tell him I sent him off the field and sent him in just to get a shower and just cool off. He just wasn't feeling great. He doesn't want to ever come out, but we have to make sure we do a good job of managing him. And our staff does a great job. Gabe, our trainers do a great job. brought to my attention, and he argued with me for about 5 minutes. And I said, get in and hit the showers. But so that was prior to treatment. Had the treatment, and then he fell a little bit on Friday. He got a little bit sick again, but came back and was good out there today. He wants to play, you know, as you know, he's missed a lot. So the live reps today was important to him. And I have to go get a pitch count to see how many snaps he played, but he looked good.
Where are Eccles and Mosley as far as fitting into that
group? Yeah, Eccles has got a little bit of an aggravating hamstring that he's carried over the past month or two. He's been able to do some. We've had to limit him some. So that slowed him down a little bit right now. But Quandre's out there playing some. We're moving him around a little bit. We need some, you know, we need some guys that can be versatile and play some sub packages, and so we're moving him around a little bit.
Talking about the sub packages, versatility in your secondary, how hard is that to do with the experience when you're trying to get him to learn one position, but you probably need him to play more than one?
It is. It's a bit of a struggle right now with a few guys, and you know, and that's kind of what my message to them after the scrimmage was that, you know, we've got to have a really high sense of urgency, and there's just no wasted time and no wasted reps, and you know, it's just hard for us to put them into so many different scenarios that'll happen. And they, you know, and you've heard me talk about in the past, and with this group, what worries me and what we have to really push on them is their football IQ and their intelligence and understand down and distance situations and all the little nuances. And that's extremely hard in those positions, in my opinion. You know, a lot of times those positions lower, as you get lower and closer to the ball, things happen quicker. And so we got to continue to work in that area. But it's of very high importance to me to get some of those things ironed out.
How the running backs look?
Good. Really good. Cavassier is a little banged up in the last practice. Nothing major. He wasn't able to go today, but he should be. Hopefully, he'll be back Monday. But AJ had some really good runs. He made some explosive plays, made some people miss. Again, it's nice to see him. You see him. He has another gear that can take it to another level, which was good to see. And Chris did some good things as well. He got a little banged up halfway through the scrimmage, played, but he got, I don't think, anything major.
Mark, for whatever problems you did have today, did you see the effort you were hoping to see?
I did, but, you know, there could always be more. You know, there needs to be a, you know, heightened sense of urgency, and that's what I'm looking for. You know, in particular from, you know, guys that are in question. You know, if our defense is in question, then they need to play with some urgency. And there's a difference between panicking and being urgent. And there's no sense of panic because we know they can do it, and I trust our coaches and our players, and we'll get it done. But they have to understand that they have to play with a great sense of urgency. We have no time to waste. And, you know, we got to pick it up in certain spots.
For some of the passing completions, is it a combination of good coverage, our quarterbacks not finding the open people, or wide receivers not getting open play?
I mean, all the above.
All the above.
I mean,
okay.
When a pass is incomplete, something went wrong. You know, so you know, that was really good coverage. So I'm not sure, you know. I mean, we throw a lot of passes out there every day, so I can't tell you which ones we're talking about.
Mark, now, what have you seen from the two O-linemen, in particular Fortner and Kennard, moving into larger roles this season?
I have a lot of trust in those guys. I really do. I feel good. You know, Luke's played a lot. You know, we got to get Mason, and Mason will get playing a lot as well. Darian, we have a lot of trust in him. And Nasir, you know, Nasir's really doing some good things. We really, it's good for us. We feel like we have three starting tackles again, which is good.
What was the play distribution out there today, Ron Pass?
Oh, I don't know. Run pass, I don't know.
All right, folks, thank you
very
much.
If I did know, I don't think I'd give you.
All right, folks, thank you.